Tell me how you got involved with Winter Inn.
Sure. So we moved to Lafayette Square about 4 years ago, right? Mm-hmm. About 4 years ago, and it was at that time that we joined St. Francis Xavier. We were really looking, I'm going to call it like some outreach type work is what we were looking for. And that would have been very different from anything we had ever done in the past and really challenge us quite a bit more. So so we attended one of the overview sessions and learned about the shelter that's in place here and just felt like this is exactly what we need to do. We need to get involved with this group.
All right. And so what does your involvement look like?
So we were just talking in the car that apparently this will be our fifth winter. And we've always done setup, has always been our thing. And that was one of the things that drew us to Winter's Inn, was that there are specific roles that we need volunteers to fill. And those roles happen at different times during the day, in the evening, the next morning. So it was very easy for us to find something that fit into our schedule. It wasn't a huge time commitment, a couple hours each night that we're open. Pat and I come here and handle the setup portion of the evening.
And Abby even helped us.
Yeah, sometimes our college-age daughter would come and help us out.
She was at SLU at the time, and she was also thinking, I need to contribute in some manner, so she joined us. And I mean, it's setting up beds, it's making beds, it's getting blankets,
It's real work.
And it was thinking about, what do people need? What are they going to need when they come in here? And we did learn, because the ballroom can be quite warm, that we were piling all these blankets on the bed, and finally
they
don't use them. We finally realized that that ballroom is so warm that they need to just, you know, stay on top of the blanket. But it for us, it was, what can we do to make these people more comfortable? What can we do? And just trying to think of any little thing that may help. And there's so many great volunteers that also come over. So you have the whole group that's setting up the food, and it smells so wonderful. When they get the coffee started, you're thinking, it's cozy. I'm ready for the guests to come in. And it's almost like opening your home. I mean, and to us, it felt like the church was this home we were opening for this group of young men. And that was also probably something quite surprising.
We were surprised who attends Winter's Inn. The guests come from a real variety of backgrounds. We thought we knew. We said, oh, we see these guys on the streets downtown. We know who they are. And you really don't. You get a lot of men from a lot of different backgrounds that just need a safe place to go for the night.
And it felt like, well, this is something we can do. And it maybe it seems so small, but it really made you feel like you were doing something worthwhile. These people were going to be warm tonight. They were going to have a great meal. They were going to feel safe. They were going to have a comfortable place to put their head for the night. I don't know what happens the next day, but none of us know what happened the next day anyway. So I thought this is a great thing, and it really makes you feel good when you do it.
What was the original inspiration? You said you felt like you needed to do something.
We had come from a parish that was very typical of most the Catholic parishes in St. Louis. It was very inward focused. It had a great school, and it had all the needs that go along with all those children and all the sports and all this. So all of our church involvement up to that point had really been either liturgical or somehow involved with the children and making our own
group better.
Yes, our own
parish
better.
Improving our own group.
And one of the things that really drew us to College Church in particular was this outreach, this going into the community and finding needs that need taken care of, and really, you know, really stewarding the community. And so when we got here, we knew very much so that was, like, we didn't want to be a lector, we didn't want to, you know, give out communion. It's like, we've already done that. We want to do something for other people.
For others, yeah. And it really, we knew we needed to. We absolutely knew. This is the time. We're at a different point in our life. Our children have grown, and that is a great thing to do while you're with your children and they're growing. But then there becomes this time, it was for us, it felt like, no, it's time for us to expand ourselves. And I know Abby was even telling us the other day that because we do this, the way we perceive other things outside are now, I'm going to call it, more open, more understanding, more empathetic. And even to the point, like now when Dan puts bags together for us, small bags, which we got the idea from College Church in the storage, but he puts small bags that when we see people out and about, and you know when you see them, that we have a bag that will have a comfort item in it. It's got a warm pair of socks. It's got a sandwich coupon. It's got a hand warmer. And you even had somebody like open the bag up one time, put the socks on the street,
yes,
and tell him
did.
How thankful
he
was.
Yes, he showed me his old socks.
Just
like,
to
I really
get a pair of
these.
Socks. And it's crazy. We take so much of this for granted. So it's just such small things that you just do on a daily, it kind of lives with us daily now. But again, we're excited for the Inn to open because we feel it provides this good, safe environment for people who need it.
What would you recommend? How would you talk about it with other people to encourage them to volunteer?
Well, we have talked with a couple other folks, and they'll quickly say, tell me what I can do. I want one of those bags. What are things can I do? When's the setup? And it is a little on the tricky side, the setup, because it is based on the temperature. So what I think what I...
Sometimes you get a last minute, that morning,
right,
that you're going to need to come in and volunteer that day. So it does require some flexibility,
yeah,
for the portion that we do, because I think we come in at 4 o'clock. It's from like 4 o'clock till 6 o'clock. So you kind of have to be able to free up the end of your day.
Mm-hmm.
But for a lot of the things that they need, greeters, to work in the evening, innkeepers that stay all night, you don't have to work. Mm-hmm. You can, those all happen after work is over for the day.
Right.
What we really enjoy about doing this is that it is a definite need. If we weren't housing these 14 guests, there would be no place for them to go.
There'd be nowhere for them.
It's not like, oh, if we don't do it, somebody else will do it. No, they won't.
They won't have a place. They don't have a place.
And in our experience volunteering, that's a rare treat to know that what you are doing is that that needed.
So it is pretty easy. We mark it on our calendar. It's Wednesdays and Thursdays. We mark it on our calendar,
mm-hmm,
and then you watch the weather, and you see what happens. You can always sign up. There's tons of spots to sign up, and we select things that meet our schedule, but again, like Dan said, it could be anything. You could prepare a crock of chili or soup or something, and sometimes you can do that ahead of time. Now, if you don't know what the weather's like, you may have a crock of soup on your hands, but I think as long as you just have the flexibility, and it happens in December, January, and February, it is cold. It is bitter cold, so that is always a good reminder for us too. When it's getting colder, we're remembering, and again, put it on your calendar, and you can volunteer for tons of different slots.
Mm-hmm. Thank you both.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Thanks.